It has been more than 40 years since the school teacher Gordon Sumner reinvented himself, of course, into the chart-topping, award-winning musician Sting.
From Message in a Bottle to Every Breath You Take, his songs are known by millions. And later today, he'll join the likes of Elton John, Paul McCartney, becoming a fellow, the Ivor Novello Songwriting Academy. He's been speaking to our music correspondent, Mark Savage, head of the ceremony.
Sting, welcome to BBC Breakfast.
Thank you. Good morning.
Good morning. We are here because you're being given the fellowship of the Ivor Novello's Academy. Now, for people who don't know what that is, explain why that's so important.
Yeah, it sounds a bit like Lord of the Rings, doesn't it? A fellowship. It's very meaningful to me because that's what I put on my passport. What am I? I'm a songwriter. That's my profession, and it's a profession I'm very proud of.
The first hit song you had was Roxanne. Do you remember listening to the chart countdown on Radio 1 the week that went into?
Yeah, I was in my kitchen in Bayswater on a plank on top of the ladders, painting the ceiling with some white emulsion, and I had Radio 1 on, and I suddenly recognised the song. It's Roxanne, and I literally fell off the ladder and immediately called the other guys in the band and said, we're on the radio. There, they were listening too. But nothing will ever beat that first, you know, time you hear it yourself on the radio. That is incredible.
And then you write what is, I think, the most played radio song of all time.
Well, that's interesting because the song that did have that position before that was You've Lost That Loving Feeling by the Righteous Brothers. Now, that's one of my favorite songs of all time, and I think it's from 1966. So I was 14, 15 at the time, and for one of my songs to supersede that, I still can't quite get my head around it.
I've always wondered, you wrote it in Ian Fleming's Goldeneye house.
It was in 1982 and Ian Fleming's house. Ian Fleming's desk was there, and at night I would sit and try and write songs. And I think the sum of the spirit of James Bond in this song, because it's so ambiguous, you know, it's a love song, but it's also quite sinister.
And tell me about Fields of Gold, because that's a song Paul McCartney said he wished he'd written.
Well, there are, I can't tell you how many of Paul McCartney songs I wish I'd written. So she took her love for to gaze a while upon the fields of barley. In his arms she fell as her hair came down among the fields. You know, the process of songwriting is kind of mysterious. You know, to this day, I'm not quite sure I understand it. I'm very happy when it comes, but there's no formula. My satisfaction at finishing a song lasts about 20 minutes. Wow. And then I get anxious about where the next song is coming from.
I wondered, as a professional songwriter, have you been watching the Ed Sheeran copyright trial?
Yes.
What did you make of that?
I was glad that Ed won. I think the building blocks of music we hold in common, all of us, songwriters. It cannot be owned by any one person or any entity. Much less can it be owned by a artificial machine intelligence.
What's your take on that? Because I think there've been, I guess, what you could call convincing facsimiles of music.
It's similar to the way I watch a movie with CGI, you know. It doesn't impress me at all. I get immediately bored when I see a computer-generated image. I imagine I will feel the same way about AI making music. You know, I think maybe for electronic dance music it works, but for songs, you know, expressing emotions, I don't think I will be moved by it.
But rest assured, it will be the actual human Sting who collects his award at the Ivor Novello's later today. Since I wrote my notes,
I should have... A lot of those songs really do stand the test of time, don't
Absolutely.
They?
Absolutely.
Just to hear them now, it's sound beautiful. As fresh as ever.
Beautiful.